Hi, Dr. Peter Osborne here with Web Wellness Update. And today I want to give you a lesson on cholesterol medications. There's a group of medications that doctors commonly prescribe, frequently prescribe, and those medications are called statins. And so statin drugs are designed to inhibit a particular enzyme in your body, and this enzyme's job is to produce the molecule cholesterol. So in a nutshell, statins block the production of cholesterol, thus lowering the cholesterol, thus the theory going, reduce cholesterol, reduce the risk of developing cardiovascular disease. However, there's a dirty little secret about statins that you should be aware of. The first one is this. Side effect of statins most commonly is muscular weakness and muscular pain, but there's actually a mechanism where that is induced, and that mechanism is that statins actually deplete something called CoQ10 or coenzyme Q10. You may have seen this. It's a very common supplement that's sold in health food stores, that's sold in supplement stores. CoQ10 or coenzyme Q10 is a nutrient that your body can make, but when you take the statin drug, it also blocks your body's ability to produce CoQ10. You see, cholesterol makes CoQ10. So when we block cholesterol, by default, we block the production of this nutrient. Why is that important for somebody who is trying to reduce their risk of heart disease? Here's how. CoQ10 deficiency, so if CoQ10 is low, what we end up getting is we end up getting a couple of problems. One, CoQ10 deficiency long term can actually cause congestive heart failure. And it's been very well studied and very well documented in a number of peer-reviewed medical journals that CoQ10 deficiency actually causes the heart muscle to become weak. And so what we end up having is we end up having the development of a weak heart muscle, and that's what they call congestive heart failure. And this is what leads to the swelling of the ankles and the swelling of the feet. So that's one element that we see when we artificially lower CoQ10. So again, here, remember, the point of taking a statin is that we're trying to reduce heart disease. So if we're taking a statin to reduce cholesterol and therefore reduce heart disease, but it's causing CoQ10 deficiency and creating a congestive heart failure issue, how much ground have we actually gained? So that's one element of what a CoQ10 deficiency can bring us. The other thing that a CoQ10 deficiency can cause, it can cause high blood pressure. And this has also been very well studied and very well documented. It's so well documented that actually some of the companies that produce statins actually have a patent on the drug with CoQ10 as part of it. Those patents just haven't, they haven't actually produced those drugs on the market yet, because the theory is that they're waiting for these patents, current patents, to expire, and then they're going to bring out CoQ10 mixed with statins, and they're going to have a new patent that nobody else can copy so they can protect their revenue. But anyway, CoQ10 deficiency can also cause high blood pressure. And of course, remember, what's our goal? Our goal is reduce heart disease. So now we've taken a drug to reduce heart disease, and we've induced potentially two different mechanisms that lead to heart problems. Now, there's a third element here with CoQ10 deficiency, and that third element has to do with the other side effect of a CoQ10 deficiency, and that is it causes muscular loss and muscle weakness. Now, let's think about that in terms of how that affects a person. Let's say I'm a 60-year-old man taking a statin, and I've been taking it for a couple of years to keep my cholesterol down. And over that 2-year time frame, my muscles have atrophied. They've gotten weaker. Okay? And as my muscles have gotten weaker, I've become less active, because it's harder for me to walk up the stairs. It's harder for me to go on a vacation and hike. It's harder for me to ride my bike or lift my weights, because my muscles are atrophying and they're weaker. So what happens when we reduce our exercise? Well, when we reduce our exercise, we end up increasing our risk for heart disease. So again, the synopsis here is we're taking a drug, we're taking a cholesterol lowering drug to reduce the risk, not to reduce heart disease, but to reduce the risk of developing heart disease. And in doing so, we inhibit a nutrient, CoQ10. CoQ10 deficiency can cause congestive heart failure, high blood pressure, muscle weakness, which in turn leads to inactivity, which increases our risk for heart disease. How much sense does that actually make? So my advice to you is take this information to your doctor. You can Google search CoQ10 deficiency and statins. You're going to pull up more information than you know what to do with. But take this information to your doctor and see if he doesn't have a different solution for you other than giving you a statin drug and telling you that your cholesterol is high and you're just going to have to take this drug for the rest of your life. I hope you found this useful. Dr. Osborne, have a great day.